Welcome back to Tools for Sparks. Why do we have some cable and cutters? Well, that's because these are tools that are for sparks. And really, any other tradesperson that is going to be cutting things. So this brand here, Fujiya, we're going to call them for now, Fujiya. They are a Japanese tool brand, apparently founded in 1923. So they've been around for a long time, but I'll be honest, never heard of them before. Don't think I've ever seen them. It doesn't even look familiar. However, they messaged us saying, please, can you have a look at our stuff? See what you think. Give an honest review. I always like that when companies are confident enough in their product to say, be honest about it, you know, and you can still post the video regardless. That straight away gets a thumbs up from me and respect. I would love to read some of the back for you. Maybe there's some Japanese speakers that can read some of the pack for me. I think that's something to do with leverage. Yeah, apparently these can even cut bolts and things as well, which is pretty cool. The reason I was straight away interested as well is because I feel like Japan is famous for quality workmanship, quality craftsmanship, and also cutting blades, right from the days of the samurai swords, right up to nowadays making extremely high quality kitchen knives. Thought maybe if they can do cutting blades like that, then there's no reason really why they can't make some electrical cutters. So they're insulated. It doesn't give me, or maybe it does in Japanese, it doesn't really give me a voltage rating that's insulated up to, and I can't see a VDE approval mark. So that's one thing. These definitely, I wouldn't say, are approved for live work in the UK. First thoughts, yeah, they feel okay. I'll be honest, it's a little bit tougher than what I'm used to. This feels a bit more plasticky than rubbery, but perhaps that's a good thing, because one thing I would say I notice on my croppers and side cutters is I don't find the insulation work last very long when it is made of rubber. So yeah, I'm definitely interested in trying these. Let's give them a little try. Let's get straight into it, see how sharp they are. Okay. Yeah, not too bad. Wouldn't say they're revolutionary, but just for some comparison, I've got a few different options here. Here's our Wish croppers, if you want to see them. I've actually found myself using these, funny enough. They found their way into my tool bag somehow. If you want to see that video, then follow the link. They are much sharper, but they are croppers, so maybe not a fair comparison. These are some very worn out side cutters that have been taped back together many times, made by Klein, but heavily used. They don't cut all the way through. Okay, I think we need to get Jordan back for these videos. I wonder how that hole got there. I have no idea. That's the sound of my nose growing. If you know why there's a hole in my cutters, feel free to comment in the comment section below. And then these are the Boddington ones. Oh, they feel good. I like those. Sorry, I do this every time. I'm here to review these. They're cool. They're all right. I wouldn't say these are amazing. To be honest, I probably wouldn't buy them. They feel a little bit cheap. So these are the croppers and side cutters. So these are a bit more beefy. I've got some Klein ones that are kind of equivalent to this. Similar. It's got that same insulation coating on there. Quite firm plastic. It's got holes. I know this one hasn't got holes. This one has holes on it, presumably to put some sort of bungee or something if you're working at height so it doesn't fall out. So I like that. Right, let's see how these are. I imagine this would do better because it's much higher leverage. But yeah, so obviously cut through it like butter. But that's because these are croppers. So it's a bit more of a fair comparison, actually. They're very nice. Very, very nice tools. Cutting through that 6mm cable like a hot knife through butter. My hands are only up the top there. There's almost no leverage. I think if they're at the bottom, it'd be, yeah. Okay, well, they're going in my tool bag. I like doing tools for sparks, all these tools. Let's see then. Okay, now I respect them, I'm going to give these more of a fair go. Maybe my initial thoughts were too hasty. Let's see if we can strip with them. I'm so out of practice using side cutters. Never really use side cutters, to be honest. Yeah, I mean, they're okay. I just don't really like side cutters. As a tails cutter, or if you're working a lot with large kind of tri-rated cables or something. I think they're pretty great. The blade on them is ridiculously sharp. And I think the fact they're made in Japan, I imagine it's a very high quality steel. So these, I would give a high score. Could do with that feeling a bit more comfortable if I was using it all day. The handle doesn't feel amazing, to be honest. But I guess that also probably means that they're a lot more hard wearing. Like, I'd be comfortable with that just sitting in the bottom of my tool bag, in my van. Maybe my kind of sparingly used tools box that everyone, I think, has, really. Yeah, let me know what you think of them in the comments below. And that brand, if you've ever worked with them before, tell me how to say that, please. If you're Japanese, I'm so sorry if I'm murdering the word there and the language. But yeah, that is a high quality tool. This, on the other hand, perhaps for certain applications, that'd be good. But I think for the kind of applications that I'm doing, considering this is kind of sold as the, I think, like a high leverage cutter, side cutters, I just don't think they feel as amazing. They're good quality. If you're into side cutters, they're fine. You know, the tips meet really nicely. It's a good quality, well-built tool. I'm just a little bit anti-side cutters. So I think that concludes today's video. Thank you very much for watching. If you want more comparison videos like this where we can prepare a variety of tools, then don't forget to subscribe and also comment if there's a tool you'd like to see that you're thinking of buying, you're umming and ahhing, and you want to know, you want to see it be unboxed, you want to see it up close, see the quality, then comment below. We'll buy it. We'll test it for you and we can tell you if it's good quality. Also, a lot of these tools, we review them, then we site test them, and then they end up on our main channel, Artisan Electrics, where we can then give real world reviews because they've been heavily used, heavily beaten up, like real tradesmen's tools, not all perfect and beautiful all the time. Thank you. Have a fantastic toilet session. Bedtime session. Do you know, wherever you are right now watching this, for me, tool review videos are usually perfect for those short work toilet breaks. Enjoy. See you next time.